Hey y'all, I was just sitting here minding my business. It's your girl She Nurses at She Nurses TV. Shout out to my day shift, night shift, swing shift, splitting the shift, trading the shift, whatever you doing out here. Stay safe, wear your mask, and God bless you always. I'm sitting here minding my business, as I was saying, you know, just thinking about springtime. So that's why I decided to put these flowers up here. And I said, let me just get on YouTube and just see what videos I can see, because I'm bored. Y'all, I ended up in the sign language section, honey. I ended up in the sign language section. I had to speak on this. It's some legit people out here doing sign languages and ain't talking about nothing. Y'all. So, I got four short videos that we are going to discuss, honey. Because, Lord Jesus, is there any area in the world that is not full of scammers? Anywhere, any parts of the world that is scammer free? Y'all know me, I don't care how old the videos are. If I see it and it piques my interest and I got something to say about it, I gotta speak on it. I couldn't believe it. I couldn't believe it. How many people were caught up misinterpreting shit out here via the sign language. So y'all grab your drink and your popcorn. We finna watch this mess, y'all.
Festivities in a whole new way. CBS 46's Ayanna Hughes has the story.
Some may say it's impossible to outshine Beyonce or her dance moves at her own concert, but one Atlanta interpreter gave her a run for her money.
Meet David Cowan, the star of this lively video that's exploded on social media. The 55-year-old man is a freelance sign language interpreter out of East Atlanta, whose expressive interpretation of Get Me Bodied by Beyonce and jubilant dance moves at the Atlanta Pride Festival had fans applauding all around.
No, it was a shock for me, but it was nice at the same time.
David tells me he chose this platform because it's often difficult for people who are deaf to watch the interpreter and then look over at the performer at the same time. So he uses his dance moves to help fill that void.
So I can see the performer out of the corner of my eye, and I can adapt and assume some of those motions and some of that energy into my interpretation, into my rendering. And fortunately, I have the moves to be able to do it.
Just for that, people have titled him the dancing hero. David says the viral video got much more attention than he ever expected, but considers it a blessing to represent his peers and ensure the deaf audience is just as included and into the experience as everyone else.
David has been signing at Pride for nearly two decades now, and he tells me he looks forward to breaking out some moves at Pride again next year. Reporting in Midtown, Ayanna Hughes, CBS 46 News.
Oh my goodness.
I'm loving all of that.
That is the best. Love it.
Lord, I pray that they don't strike my channel down for the music playing in the back. Now, obviously, I'm not talking about David. David did his thing. He made everybody want to get up and just do it. People got the correct lyrics. They knew what was going on. David made it fun. Had me shrugging my shoulders over here. And I don't know sign language. But I'm not talking about David. I had to give y'all some good ones along with some bad ones, okay? David, I don't know what that tongue action was about, though. Maybe he was just really feeling it. We'll just say that. Right.
In the hours before, during, and after Superstorm Sandy, New York Mayor Michael Bloomberg's press briefings were critical. Yet often, it was someone else who caught everyone's eye. Lydia Callis, the mayor's mesmerizing sign language interpreter.
Whose expressive sign language interpreting turned disaster press briefings into an Alvin Ailey sign language recital.
Her signs are set to music. There's a Gangnam Style spoof.
Open Gangnam Style.
And this on Saturday Night Live.
With a special thanks to my sign language translator, Lydia Callis, who brought some pizzazz to what would otherwise have been a dour occasion.
I did want to bring, did you see Saturday Night Live?
I did. did.
Thought so.
Callis arrived for our interview with her own interpreter.
Were you surprised by the reaction?
I actually was very surprised, naturally. I was a bit overwhelmed. But at the same time, I felt like, wow, this is great. If this is what's going to shine light and bring it to the deaf community and the culture and the language, then it's a beautiful thing, and I'm all for it.
2 to 4 out of every 1,000 Americans are functionally deaf.
What was this all about when you were doing that?
Those are signs for the storm.
Okay.
So when you have wind, you would go like this for wind.
Wind.
Yes.
Callis's mom and 3 siblings are deaf. Sign language was her first language.
If you watched any of the news reports, you could see that I was signing, but I was also mouthing the words as well, because you have people that are completely deaf, cannot read lips, cannot speak, and rely solely on sign language. And then you have people at the complete other end of the spectrum who are oral and can speak for themselves and have some hearing, who are hard of hearing and can't understand sign language.
But why so expressive?
His tone was very fierce, it was very strong, and I had to portray that through my message and my facial expressions, because it was important for people to know that if they were in Zone A, it was immediate danger and they needed to evacuate their homes as soon as possible.
She also follows the news, so she knows how to sign words like surge and crane. Then there are times the message for the deaf and the hearing are one and the same.
In one of the pictures that was taken of me and the mayor, we are looking at one of the reporters. We both have our hands in the air looking at the reporter like, are you kidding me?
Callis says it's all about interpreting the mayor's message as faithfully as possible. Her fans say. Alina Cho, CNN, New York.
Now, obviously, I'm not talking about Lydia either. Her first language was sign language due to her siblings being deaf. So, wow, kudos to you, Lydia. So, let's get into the bullshit.
It wasn't urgent. Hurricane Irma evacuation order. But look at the sign language interpreter on
yes,
the right.
Law enforcement
He's
is
actually
off
signing total
to
gibberish. What's he really communicating to deaf citizens caught up in the hurricane crisis? Words like pizza, monsters, and the
yes.
sentence,
no, tomorrow,
help you at that time
tomorrow,
to use bear hug. Deaf actress Marley Matlin posted, this is outrageous.
Please heed our warnings.
The interpreter's name is Marshall Green. Officials in Manatee County asked Green to step in because no one else was available. His mom, brother Morgan, who is hearing impaired, and Morgan's fiance Chasa are coming to his defense today.
He, told them he didn't think that he was able to do it, and they felt like that they needed him to. So he said yes. The vocabulary for an evacuation is very different than everyday language.
I'm just asking, as someone hearing impaired, what your reaction is to this criticism.
Chasa signed my question to Morgan.
He only did what he was told to do, so please leave our family alone.
Unlike Marshall Green, another sign language expert is being praised for his Hurricane Irma work. Sam Harris became an overnight viral star for his vivid translation of Florida Governor Rick Scott's dire warnings.
Say hello to Sam Harris.
Harris was invited to sign Jimmy Kimmel's monologue, and he got big laughs.
The iPhone 10 comes with everything the iPhone has, but it also includes an amazing new feature that takes $300 more out of your checking account. I have a feeling I'm going to be out of a job at the end of this.
Maybe he can give this guy some lessons.
Okay, obviously we're going to be talking about the guy in the yellow shirt. So this happened a few years back, so I'm not trying to offend the family. So hopefully they're laughing about it now. But during an emergency evacuation, you talking about pizza, monsters, and hugging bears? Come on, Mr. Huggy Bear. I know your family is taking up for you, and they're saying that you were sort of peer pressured into doing it. You should have just said no. I politely declined because I don't know just fluent sign language in all kinds of terms. You know what I'm saying? Don't get on TV and make a fool out of yourself talking about food and monsters and hugging bears, Mr. Yellow Shirt. I need a where are they now? I really need a where are they now. If anybody knows, please tell me, because I really need to know a where are they now. Let's get into the next bullshit.
As you recall, on October 9th, Benjamin Mitchell was 22 years old, and he was murdered. That was 51 days ago. On October 11th, 2 days later, 32-year-old Monica Hoffa was murdered. 8 days later, on October 19th, Anthony Nyboa murdered. 26 days later, on November 14th, just 2 weeks ago, 60-year-old Ronald Felton was murdered. We received over 5,000 tips in this case. I am pleased to announce that tonight we will be making an arrest in the Seminole Heights murders. Our detectives are currently working on the charging documents, and we will be charging four counts of first-degree murder for Howe Emanuel Donaldson III, 24 years old. Now, unfortunately, I will not have the answers that you are going to want. This is an ongoing situation. We responded out to the area about 2:30 this afternoon. We received some information about Mr. Donaldson having a firearm at the McDonald's. One of his coworkers approached a police officer. That is what led us to that. Through our investigation, several hours later, we will be charging Donaldson, like I said, with four counts of first-degree murder. I would like to thank the Bureau of Alcohol, Tobacco. I think when I found out there was a gun, that and when we looked at his description, it gave us a little more than what we've ever really had. We've run down some guns before, run into some other things. It just felt right. I kind of had a feeling that we were going to get a break. You know, every day we would meet as a group and we would say, what day is it? And today was day 51. And we discussed yesterday, I said, we're going to get a break this week. I was trying to be optimistic. I have a tendency to be, my glass is half empty sometimes. And so I wanted to kind of pump everybody up. And for whatever reasons, we got a break. Somebody stepped up and did the right thing. And that's what we needed. We had said all along that no tip is too small, and somebody stepped forward and gave us what we needed. Unfortunately, we knew by coming out here tonight that we would probably create a lot more questions, but the real goal is to let the people of Seminole Heights be able to get a good night's sleep. It's been 51 days that they've been terrorized in their neighborhood, and it is about letting these families know that we're going to bring this person to justice and letting this neighborhood get some rest and hopefully try and put their lives back together.
Were you able to talk to any of the families yet?
Yes, I talked to my mayor.
You know, 51 days ago, I said this was a struggle between good and evil. Well, tonight, goodness has won. Tonight, in the battle between darkness and light, light has won. It would not have happened without the amazing police work. I can't tell you, and I know I speak for the people of Seminole Heights, who stood up with us shoulder to shoulder, who never left during the tough times, who never quit on us, nor did they ever quit on the men and women of law enforcement. They had our backs and we had theirs. We could not have done this without their support and the support of this entire community. Tonight is the beginning of when justice will be served. And then the process will occur when this individual rots in hell.
Now, let me start by saying she is not the only one. There are more now. There are more like her and Mr. Yellow Shirt out there, y'all. Now, family members, please don't get mad at me. I'm just trying to make the people laugh during this pandemic, okay? Because this shit was funny and y'all know it too, whether you laugh in her face or behind her back, okay? Make it make sense. I'm just gonna be honest, she had me fooled. She could have fooled me because I don't know sign language like that. But I couldn't help but to notice how much she was moving for a little bit, like she was the hype man in a music concert. I'm like, well, damn, girl. When he said shoulder to shoulder and she put them fists on each hip, honey, I died. Hollered. But she's known for scamming. But how y'all let her scam y'all like that? I mean, she was so serious, y'all. Did y'all see how she kept looking up like, Lord, help me? Because you know, you and I both know, Lord, I'm doing some bullshit down here. Please don't strike me down. Don't strike me down. It's like she was looking up like, Lord, give me grace. Sign language, sign language. Give me mercy, Lord. Sign language, sign language. Now, we're talking about murder here. Murder. Can you imagine all the people that are deaf and speak sign language only that was looking at her like, what in the entire F are you talking about? I don't even know her name, but right now she looked like a Gloria. She looked like a Gloria to me, honey. Everybody just so serious. Look at a child. Ooh-wee. Even the sign language ain't safe. It ain't safe. It ain't safe. It ain't safe, y'all. I mean, them fingers was working. I ain't gonna say she didn't get some of it right, but baby, she was looking up to the high heavens like, Lord, come on now. Help me be creative up here. It's like when you're doing wrong and you looking up like, please don't let me be found out. I bet the sign language community was like, can we sue her? Can we sue her for doing this to us? Whoo, child. I bet they tore her up when this first came out. Y'all know they tore her up. Oh, I wonder if she got charged. I need a where are they now? Somebody update me, because right now I'm just too lazy to follow up on it. I may do a follow-up just because I want to know, but if y'all could kindly put it in the comment section, I love y'all forever. But right now, honey, she got me looking like Nicole TV. She got my eyelash gone and my hair gone. Snatched it right off with those extra movements she was doing. Baby, no. Well, y'all already know. I hope y'all got a good kiki like I did, honey, because that I was thoroughly entertained. But she left me just like this, just like Nicole TV. That's how she left me. Looking abused and confused. Sign language community, y'all stick together. I'll talk to y'all later. Bye.